it is a strange book because I was invited by the academic hospital in Amsterdam to write a book about the hospital. And they allowed me to choose a specialism, and I wanted to write about anesthesia. So I read a lot about it and interviewed a lot of people who worked as anesthetists in the hospital. And then I was allowed for a few months to be there and see them work in the operating theaters and during the night and that kind of thing. And I thought it was really nice to be able to get to know a whole new world, which I didn't know much about. And I chose that area because it is such an opposition to my own kind of work. I always worked as a psychoanalyst and a psychoanalytic psychotherapist. And in my kind of work, you think pain is a good thing. If a patient can experience pain and experience feelings about pain, then I'm glad as a therapist, because that's the real person who feels pain. But in the hospital, they think pain is a kind of foe. They fight the pain. As soon as a patient feels pain, they come with their syringes and morphine and all kinds of things to keep away the pain. So I thought it was nice, this opposition. And I soon had a plan to write about those two professions. And I thought about a brother and a sister. The brother is a psychoanalyst. He is 4 years older than the sister, and she is the anesthesia specialist. And I thought about a psychological explanation of those professions. And I gave them a mother who died when the sister was only a half a year old. But the boy was 4 years old, and he already had language and could speak and could think in words. So his profession is the profession with the words. He becomes a psychiatrist and then a psychoanalyst. But she has no words at all. She has a profession where she only is active in doing things. So I had characters and then, a kind of hospital romance develops, because I like to play with those cheap books about doctors and nurses who fall in love with each other. Being a psychoanalyst is something that it influences your way of looking at people, thinking about people, and you can't put it out like you put out a coat or something. It becomes how you think. And I always want to have an explanation for my characters, how they have become the person they are, and then perhaps when the story develops, they can step out of their roles. But you must be able to understand how they have become like they are now. Well, I think it's the only book I wrote with no music in it. I was so occupied by this hospital and all the things I learned that I had no, there was no need to put music into the book. I am a writer and I am a psychoanalyst, but I think music is my greatest love. I always wanted to be a pianist, and my parents and teachers didn't think that was a good idea, so I had to go to university, and I did. But after the psychology studies, I thought I will not be a person who always says, I wanted to be a pianist, but they didn't allow it. So after those studies, I went to the conservatoire and became a pianist. And I think that playing the piano or playing another instrument is a very healthy thing for people to do. It takes all your faculties. You have to think, you have to feel, you have to use your muscles. And during the practice time, you can't think about anything else. So all worries go back.